Well, good morning. This is Scott over at Ready Squirrel. Today we're going to talk about something that we don't all like to think about, but I think is critical for emergency or survival situation, especially when you're thinking about something like hurricane preparedness, and that is a poop bucket. Yes, exciting. All right, so I'm just going to show you quickly how to make one. It's simple. It's something you can do ahead of time, and I think it's critical. These are the things you're going to need. One is the small version of the pool noodle. I wouldn't get the big ones because they don't fit the rim of the bucket very well. And these work well. I got two of these at Walmart for 79 cents. You're also gonna want some pine bedding, unless you're lucky enough to have, you know, wood chips from a pine tree. I bought this at Walmart. You can also get these, the pine pellets at Tractor Supply. A lot of people that are boondocking, that is like RVing without power, and they're using composting buckets and toilets, they're using pine. Pine is better than kitty litter. Pine is better than other types of wood chips because it keeps the odor down. And that's one of the main things that we want to go for. The other thing that you're going to need is a utility or an X-Acto knife, and you're gonna want a 5 gallon bucket. I'm starting with a clean one. Got it at Walmart. I bought everything for $8.46. The bucket, two noodles, and the pine straw. I already had the utility knife, and I already had small kitchen size trash bags. Okay, so let's get down to it. Okay, so the first step is you want to cut 31 inches of pool noodle off. This is for a regular 5 gallon bucket. I've already done this once, so I know the measurements are spot on. I've seen some stuff that says 3 feet, but that was too big for my bucket. Okay, 31 inches. I'm going to cut that crosswise. Be careful when you're doing this, you don't cut yourself. Okay, 31 inch pool noodle. Okay, the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna cut the pool noodle lengthwise on one side. So the first pass through, I scored it, and then the second pass through, I'm going to go ahead and cut all the way through. So then what you come up with is, and this is going to go around the rim of the bucket. Okay, so you've cut your noodle to size, you've got your seat cut 31 inches long, and you've cut it down the center. Next thing you want to do is line your 5 gallon bucket with a trash bag. Okay, the next step, you want to add some pine animal bedding into the bucket, like 2 inches. That way you've kind of got a substrate, something to go pate on. Okay, the next step, somebody's gone to the bathroom in there. Those are actually baby Ruths in honor of Bill Murray. So every time you go to the bathroom, you're gonna wanna cover that up. That'll keep the odor down. So it's as simple as that. Okay, so one other thing you can do with this, you don't have to if you don't want to, but you can actually put your TP on the handle. Just pop it back in. Maybe not just, but pop it back in. Good to go. So you want to keep bugs off this. My guess, I mean, it depends on the weather. You probably want to have this outside if you can, if possible. But one other thing that you can do that I think is kind of a simple method. These pool noodles just do not like to stay on here on their own. They're definitely worth having, and you can definitely have a more comfortable sit on this. But one of the other things you can do when you're done, or no, when nobody's using it, especially if it's outside, to keep the bugs out, is just get another trash bag the same size, and you can go over the whole thing. The toilet paper, the top of the bucket, everything. So you're keeping your toilet paper dry, and you see that noodle wants to come off. But you can see you're keeping your toilet paper dry here on the handle. There's some other things that you can do to this. You can drill some holes just on the outside, put a bungee cord in here to have the handle stick up so the toilet paper rolls easier. I wouldn't put my toilet paper on here personally. I would actually have a separate bucket I'd have a separate bucket with hygiene products, like hand cleaner, extra toilet paper, extra bags, extra wipes, hand soaps, maybe a flashlight for a nighttime, if you have to go to the potty and it's not like right by your tent, which you probably don't want it to be. So all the things that you would need to use to use your poop bucket, you want to have, in my opinion, in a separate bucket, all your hygiene, all your sanitation kit in that bucket. And I would also leave my toilet paper in there. So basically just have another 5-gallon pail with a lid. I would have this pre-made just like what we've done here. And I would put the noodle down inside the bucket, and I would put the extra toilet paper inside the bucket and the extra bags. And I would have a lid on both the sanitation bucket and the poop bucket. Know where they're at, have them pre-staged, and they're ready to go. You don't have to do anything. And if you're using them and you have lids, especially for the products, for the hand cleaning products and stuff, then you're insured that, one, that they're not going to get wet, and two, you actually will have like a little table next to your bucket. You know what I'm saying? So you could, if it's nice out, you could actually leave your TP up there. You could leave some hand wash up there. Some people have suggested using a water basin, like a small plastic basin, filling that with fresh water and then using that to wash your hands. I don't like that idea, but that is a possibility if that's something you're interested in. Okay, so that's it. That's how to make a poop bucket. I think it's critical to have something like this, to have a means to go poo and pee. One other issue is some people are taking these buckets and they're making one for poop and one for pee. The pee really is what smells. But I think in an emergency situation, you don't want to be, may not necessarily want to be dealing with two buckets. You got the bag, you've got the pine chips to suppress the smell. How to get rid of these bags, that's going to be something you're going to have to research on your end. The military burns it with diesel. You can bury it as long as it follows guidelines and laws. You can bury it as long as it's not close to water or habitation. And I mean bury it deep. You can actually do what's called humanure, major turnoff for a lot of people, but universities like Cornell are looking into this, and people are, permaculturalists are using it. They're actually composting human manure. I would not put it on something like vegetables, but you could use it for things like trees and stuff like that. It takes like a year process. So why would you want to make one of these? Keep in mind that I think some of the people in Puerto Rico were without flushable toilets for months. So this could be actually critical to staying healthy, even if you've got enough food and water. So this is, I mean, it's very simple, but it's probably something that's good. It's a good idea to do something like this ahead of time.